Hi and welcome to another video on my YouTube channel. Thanks for tuning in. At the moment I'm working on a sound set for the Yamaha EX5, also known as the best synthesizer ever built. And it's a slow progress. At the moment I'm at patch number 36 out of 128 possible patches and coming up with something original which hasn't been done a million times before is quite challenging. And there was this random discovery I just made that I wanted to share with you, and it's possible to use coupler strong synthesis on the EX5. I was quite surprised it worked. And what is it? Well, it's the repetition of a sound so fast that the repetition frequency itself moves into the audible range so you can hear it. And the resulting sound is somewhat like a string being plucked. Let's take a closer look. Okay, I want to show you what I'm talking about on the peak first, because it's easier to show the principles here. What we want to do is to have only a short burst of noise. So I'm dialing down the oscillators a little bit and the noise all the way up. Let's listen. There's this noise. Now, what we want to do is fairly fast decay and all the other sustained release values all the way down. So now we have a very short burst of noise now. And what we want to do now is to repeat this noise. And on the peak, we can do this by using the delay and putting all values to the maximum value. You can hear. There's the delay. Now I will set the time here to the lowest possible value. Let's listen. Yeah, you can hear it's possible to use this on the peak, but the problem here is as there's only one delay effect, you can only use this monophonic. It's possible to tweak the delay time here with the mod matrix of the synth, so you can play melodies actually, which is quite cool. But it's only monophonic. Now let's have a look at the EX5. Okay, this is the EX5. We've got a fresh voice and I will edit this now. And the first thing we want to do is change the synth engine to FDSP. So this is the engine which can take any note you play and modify it using some algorithms. And we're going to use that because we want to individually modify every note we play. And the next thing is we want to go to the oscillators page, and now we want to select noise on the first oscillator, and it's the wave number 287. It's noise. Let's listen. There you have it. It's noise. Now let's dial down the reverb a little bit. Okay. And what we want to do now is to go to the amplitude page and then on envelope generator and just create short burst of noise like this. Okay. Maybe a little bit longer. That seems okay to me. And now let's head over to the common page once again and then press on FDSP. And what we want to do now is to select the water effect. So first we turn on the FDSP engine for oscillator 1, and now we will select the type here, and here it is, water. Now listen to this. You can hear the noise is still audible, but there's this water effect superimposed onto it. And what we're going to do now is to change the parameters a little bit. So we will get a very different sound. And we will leave the pitch coarse and pitch fine of the effect just as it is. That's fine because it corresponds to the notes we're playing. And we'll leave the key follow value there at on 32 as well, because this just means that with every note you play, the frequency of this effect will change accordingly. But we will set the frequency of the effect to zero, so it doesn't change at all. Hear the difference before, after, just a little bit. So now we will leave this value as it is, and the resonance is resonance of the filter effect. So let's change that to zero. So now this bubbly sound effect has disappeared. We will set the frequency modulation just slightly down. You'll see why that is later. And the modulation speed will also be just a little bit less than this. So, and we want to smoothen the modulation a little bit. And the feedback is okay like it is, and the key following of the feedback is okay as it is. And what we want to do now is change this value. This is some sort of low pass filter, and the lower the number over here, the more of the high frequencies get filtered away. So let's choose the highest setting possible, and now let's listen again. Okay, now we're getting somewhere, and we'll leave this value as it is. And the release time is what you expect, how fast this effect will fade away. For example, if I set this to 10, it slowly fades away, but at 48 it will just go on a little bit more. Okay, let's also set the high pass filter a little bit higher, so the lower frequencies of noise will get filtered away. Okay, and we want to increase the wet level, which means the ratio of the effects output compared to the basic signal or bass signal. So this is the maximum value possible. And the dry level, we will just put it down a little bit. You can of course set it to zero, so the noise will completely disappear. Yeah, and there you have it. This totally sounds like a string being plucked. And if you want to get rid of this mandolin effect, which I don't, I like it, you can use the modulation smoothness. Yeah, and that's it. There you have it. String synthesis on the EX5. Okay, and here's the patch, the finished patch I included in my sound set. I've tweaked the settings just a little bit and added some more waveforms, and let's listen to this. Yeah, and that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this episode. I certainly did. And yeah, I will notify you if my sound set is ready for download. I will publish that on this channel. And until then, yeah, have a good week and see you next week. Bye bye.